I thought we should take a look at two more examples of problems when we're given an equation and asked to isolate a particular variable. Here we're given the equation A equals 1/2 times the quantity B sub 1 plus B sub 2 times H, and we want to solve this equation for B sub 1. And this does happen to be the formula to determine the area of a trapezoid, where B sub 1 and B sub 2 are the lengths of the two parallel sides, and H is the height. The important thing to remember here is whatever we do to one side of the equation, we must also do to the other to maintain equality. Now, it might be tempting to distribute the h or maybe even the 1/2, but I think that might just complicate things. Let's start by seeing if we can undo this 1/2 here. And if we multiply 1/2 by its reciprocal, it will simplify to 1. So let's multiply both sides of the equation by 2, or 2 over 1. So I'll multiply the right side of the equation by 2 over 1, since we're multiplying this by a fraction, and I'll multiply the left side just by 2, since this is not in fraction form. And now on the right side, these 2's simplify out, so this simplifies to 1. So we have 2a on the left, and on the right side now we have the quantity b sub 1 plus b sub 2 times h. Now this h is attached to this quantity by multiplication, so we can isolate the quantity b sub 1 plus b sub 2 by dividing both sides by h. So now we have 2a divided by h equals b sub 1 plus b sub 2. So now we're almost there. And now we're almost there. Remember, we're trying to isolate b sub 1, and we can do that by subtracting b sub 2 on both sides. So on the left side, we have 2a divided by h minus b sub 2 is equal to b sub 1. So now we've solved this equation for b sub 1. Let's take a look at one more example. Here we're given the equation 2x minus 3y equals 8, and we want to solve this equation for y. So we don't want this 2x on this side, as well as this negative 3 or minus 3. So we'll start by adding or subtracting on both sides, and we can undo this positive 2x on the left side by subtracting 2x on both sides of the equation. So this would be 0. We're left with negative 3y equals, I'm going to go ahead and put the x term first, we'll have negative 2x plus 8. So now we have negative 3 times y equals negative 2x plus 8. So to solve this equation for y, we'll divide both sides by negative 3. So this simplifies to y, and on the right side we have negative 2x plus 8 divided by negative 3. Now we have solved the equation for y, which is what this question asks us to do. But if we go back up to the original problem just for a moment, this is actually the standard form of a line, and often what we'll do in order to graph a line like this is write it in the slope-intercept form, which is in the form of y equals mx plus b. So let's go ahead and rewrite this in a different form. Because we're dividing by a monomial, we can break this up into two fractions. We'd have negative 2x divided by negative 3 plus 8 divided by negative 3. So to simplify this, we would have y equals, and negative divided by a negative is positive, so this would be positive 2/3 x. And then instead of plus a negative 8/3, we can just say minus a positive 8/3. This would be the more common form. Again, it really depends on your textbook or your instructor. This is solve for y, so we could stop here. But if we do want to write it in slope-intercept form, which is common for graphing, we would want to express it in this form here. But both are correct because we have solve for y.